So Mario Kart 9 is in the news because some insider analyst person is apparently saying that it's in development. And it's probably fake, because I've been looking for this news for like 6 years now. But the thing of interest is that the claim is that there's some new gameplay twist. As a result, everyone is saying that that twist is Nintendo Kart, because if there's one group of people that struggle with thinking of new creative outside of the box ideas, it's us Nintendo fans. When thinking about new gameplay mechanics traditionally, they've been hit or miss. You know, Double Dash had, well, the Double Dash mechanic, Mario Kart Wii had the bikes and tricks, even if, you know, they killed the carts in the process. And recently, MK7 added gliding and underwater driving, and MK8 topped it off with anti-gravity driving. Now, I don't think that they're going to do a logical progression from Mario Kart 8. I think they like to usually reset after two games or so, have something really new and clever. You know, you had the DS and Wii, then you had the 7 and 8. But when I think of the game that had the best new features, among all of these, I think of Mario Kart DS. Did they introduce any new groundbreaking gameplay features? No, they actually didn't. They simply added retro tracks and Nintendo Wi-Fi play, and with other cool things like missions and emblems, this game stood the test of time as my favorite one in the series. The notion that there has to be some new innovative twist drives me insane personally, because sometimes content is enough. Smash Ultimate was all about the content, and everyone loves that game. And when people talk about Brawl, I think of things like Subspace, not the introduction of the Smash Ball. So why does Mario Kart have to be so different where they can't just make a good game for the sake of making a good game? They've been a lot more shameless before in rehashes, and you know, Mario Kart games sell regardless. The idea of Nintendo Kart gets me thinking though. Does this actually change gameplay at all? Like, is this a gameplay feature change? And the answer I think is not really. When you play Link in Smash Bros., you feel like you are Link. Like, you run around, you've got the arrows, and you can throw boomerangs and place bombs. It makes sense. But in Mario Kart 8, when you play Link, you're kind of like, yeah, I'm Link. And then he goes on the title screen, and that's about the extent of his contributions to the game. He controls like any other character in the game would, because let's be real here, you're not using characters, you're using the cars they play in. Character roster is less significant than the tracks when talking about new content that actually affects gameplay in the series. Do I think it'd be cool for Meta Knight to be in the game? I guess, but I don't really need him in a go-kart. It doesn't change much at all. So you may be asking, if the new twist does end up being Nintendo Kart, why would I care? It sounds like a Mario Kart game with new content that doesn't have unnecessary gameplay changes. Well, that may not be true, because if they change Mario Kart to Nintendo Kart, I think it would start to affect the game at large. This wouldn't just mean adding Sephiroth to the game or anything, this would mean things like items and tracks would likely be affected. Look, Mario Kart has struggled with item balance for a long time. I think they're getting it right finally, but the first few games that came out were pretty horrible in this regard, and that's why all the serious players of, like, you know, the classic games stuck to time trialing. Items didn't work half the time, or you'd just pull things in spots that were just unfair for everyone involved. The good news is I think they've recently hit a home run with item balance in Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, and I have confidence that they can get it right if they only add, you know, a few upgrades and, you know, new things. But if you really think about what they've added recently, you start to worry if you think of a setting where they may add like 10 different things. Now, I think a lot of people like the bullet bill, but since then there have been a lot of misses on the new items. You know, with the bill they introduced the blooper, which literally nobody enjoys obtaining because it feels useless. Then you move on to Mario Kart Wii, where the Mega Mushroom is kinda cool, but it makes the already powerful sandbagging game centered around shock dodging even more broken. The POW was an interesting item, especially when playing in teams, but it may have not been used to its fullest potential when the item balance dictated that some players, you know, drive backward. In the Thundercloud, well, you all know the story on that one. Mario Kart 7 was when the item started getting out of hand, though. The Firefighter was a spawn of the devil, and the Tanuki Leaf was so powerful up front that if you were in first with one, sometimes you would just want to not drive and instead stop to hit close opponents because you couldn't really miss with them. The Lucky 7 was fine enough, but most people just use it kind of as a star. And then you get to Mario Kart 8, where they introduce the Piranha Plant, an item that requires no individual thought whatsoever, and it's best to just use it immediately to clear up your inventory. And then the Boomerang, the Hellspawn best friend of the Fire Flower, existed. What a combo those are. The Super Horn was also added here, which in my opinion was the first great item introduced since 2005. None of these were particularly game-breaking. I liked all the games, but the point is, balancing this stuff is difficult, and if you're rebranding the entire game, you're going to probably have more items that are not just Mario items, And you best believe that balancing all the new potential new chaotic stuff is going to be an incredible challenge. Like, you're going to be starting more or less from the ground up again and seeing what works and what doesn't. And I don't think that they're going to be able to make a game more balanced than Mario Kart 8 Deluxe if they're, you know, rebranding everything. I wouldn't be surprised if the game played out more similarly to one of the older MK games like MK64. What also comes to mind is the track selection, because there may be some interesting new possibilities. We've seen some of the ideas already. But what would make me sad about this possibility is that they may decide to can the need for retro tracks to really round out the list if they have more options from different series. And the retro tracks were one of my favorite things about the newer games because it allowed you to play some of your old favorites from childhood online in new settings with friends and stuff. Like, I'm trying to play Banshee Boardwalk at some point in time, but because it came back so early in Mario Kart DS without Wi-Fi, that may never happen. But there are so many that I still want to return, and by that I mean Wario Coliseum. Please bring back Wario Coliseum. I've waited so long. Please just do it. Tracks and items aside, I feel like it's just wrong to change the series. I don't know why, but this is just how I feel as somebody who's played for a long time. And as much as I think that the character rosters in these games don't really matter, maybe people would not feel the need for this if they actually put in the Mario characters that are deserving and that people want in the game instead of, like, you know, clone characters. But who am I kidding? This will probably never happen anyway. So, do you want a Nintendo Kart? Comment below or something on what you want. At this point, I just want something new and fresh, and, you know, fake news about a new Mario Kart game coming out is kind of exciting because I got to make a video or something. But at this point, I would prefer just a normal follow-up to Mario Kart 8. You know, not Mario Kart 8 Deluxe or something like that. Like a new one entirely, preferably not a mobile game also, or, you know, whatever home circuit was. No arcade game, like just a new one for Switch, please. That's all I'm asking for. But I would prefer it to be a normal follow-up if I had the choice. Alright, that's about it for now. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one.